Hello, I'm Ulrich Morgenstern, Professor for History and Theory of Folk Music at the Department for Folk Music Research and Ethnomusicology at the University of Music and Performing Arts, Vienna. One of my favorite topics are folk musical instruments of Europe, different countries of Europe. And when we talk about musical instruments, very important is the material they are made of. It determines the shape and in some way the music played. And wood is one of the materials fundamental to human culture and also to musical culture. We know wooden flutes, also bone flutes. Of course, music archaeology better knows the bone instruments than the wooden, because bones are preserved longer and easier. But the idea of making instruments of wood is very old. And the way of working with the wood in different historical periods is very different. This is a Byzantine lyre. I bought it in Crete, in the island of Crete, from an old instrument maker. And this is an unbroken tradition making such instrument from Byzantine time, because boat instruments came to Europe from Byzantium. And what is interesting about this instrument? The technique is monoxyle. So that means you take a single block of wood and form it from inside, from outside, you carve it out. And then, of course, you add the top, but the body and the neck of the instrument is made from one piece of wood. Then later, in the Renaissance period, they made both instruments in the composed technique, as we know from violins and other instruments. Plucked lutes also were made in the same technique. This is a reconstructed Russian balalaika. You may be surprised the balalaika is triangular and has three strings, yes, but only after the standardization in the late 19th century. In the late 18th and early 19th century, balalaikas also were made like this from one block of wood. In this case, it's birch wood, so the whole instrument, except the top and, of course, the strings and the bridge, is one piece of wood. So this is another type. This technique with these beautiful stripes is more complex, more advanced, and it came to Russian from Central Asia. Here we already have three strings. It is from the Volga-Ural region where craftsmanship was very developed. Other instruments look more archaic. Let's take this children instrument. For children, particularly for boys, working with wood is very important. And until recently, and sometimes even now, in the villages, most of the young boys are able to make flutes or some toys, some musical toys by themselves. And it's surprising how similar these instruments are to each other all over Europe. Wherever you find wood, some musical instruments, particularly the more archaic ones, are very similar. So here we have flutes made of elder. Elder, it is very a good material for making flutes and other wind instruments because you can hollow the tube very easily, because it is, you just have to take out the flexible material in the middle, and here you have a hollow tube. You can use it for flutes, also for reed instruments, like this. So children instruments, this is a very important chapter in the history of mankind. It's about human creativity, about human inventiveness, and of course the pleasure of music. Music is not always played for pleasure, but sometimes also it is directly connected with human work, for example with the profession of the shepherds. Shepherds use musical instruments for signals, to communicate with each other. And this is from Burgenland, Austria, a sort of oboe. The reed is missed, but here the bell is still existent. It is made only from birch. So many shepherd instruments look like this. Before they start using metal or horns. For example here, this reed instrument, it is from Russian. It is a reconstruction of a shepherd instrument because the shepherd stopped playing this instrument some decades ago, maybe half a century ago. So this is a sort of clarinet, a reed pipe with only three holes. And the bell is made by birch bark. You can also do similar instruments. This is a chanter of a reconstructed bagpipe with a cow horn. Again, the elder instrument. This primitive wood, but you can prepare it with lime oil and it will look very nice. What is interesting about this instrument? It is a double reed pipe from South Russian, from the region of Belgorod. And traditionally, it should be made with a cow horn. But at present, it is not so easy to find cow horns even in South Russian villages. So the maker then found out that in Central Russian, they made similar instruments with this stripe of birch bark. But he didn't take birch bark, but some synthetic stripe, and then prepared it with lac. Maybe for us it doesn't look so like. It doesn't look so nice because some enthusiasts of folk culture are a bit romantic and we like the natural materials more. But it is interesting to see how flexible the musical cultures works. That means the carriers of the traditional cultures are sometimes less romantic, they think more practical. They use the material they have at hand. And in pre-industrial culture, this was, of course, a great deal the wood. So this is an instrument from the Novgorod region in northwest Russian. It is called gusli and belongs to the family of the Baltic Psaltery. Modern instruments are composed like a box, but this is also made in the traditional way. This is a reconstruction. And it is also made in the monoxyle technique. That means from one piece of wood. So one piece of wood, spruce, you take, and the pegs are made of birch bark. Here it is interesting that the whole block of wood is added only not like this instrument, like the lira, the top is inserted, but the bottom of the instrument. So only here a desk is inserted and all the other instruments except the peck is made from a single piece of wood. What is interesting about the technique of making these instruments? As we know from our Russian colleagues who did fieldwork in the late 20th century, they were told that the tools these instruments were made are quite limited. This very instrument, can you imagine, was made only, not this, but so to say, the prototype, the instrument, it was made in the traditional way, was made only with an axe and a knife. No other tools. The same thing with fiddles. I had a photo from one fiddle from the, even bigger than this instruments, four string, highly developed fiddle, which was made only with an axe and a knife. So craftsmen were very clever and they knew how to use the instruments. This is again about human creativity. And it is also very teaching if you try to make the instruments by yourself, what you have to think of, what is the functionality of the instrument, why the instrument looks like it looks. It has mainly to do with stability, with of course with acoustical properties. So this is very teaching for anyone who studies musical instruments, at least folk musical instruments. If you try to make it, at least at some level by yourself. What is also important when we talk about traditional folk musical instruments, they are sometimes considered to be national, particularly in popular discourses. But if we have a closer look, we can recognize that traditionally there are not so much instruments connected only with one nation. Let's take the balalaika. This is a reconstruction of a so-called Little Russian, that means Ukrainian balalaika, from the districts of Poltava. It has four strings, not three, as most modern balalaikas. So the balalaika is an instrument which, with the same name or with other names, was used also by not only by the Russians. And particularly important are the parallels with the Central Asian and with the Caucasian instruments. This is also a instrument from Georgia. This is the panduri. Here even the frets are wooden. Not from gut, but fixed frets from wooden. Also some similarities with the balalaika. But in this particular shape, it is more widespread in Georgia. Because the shape of the instruments usually doesn't depend on the nation, but to a great deal, it depends on natural areas. There are some more instruments very widespread in Europe I want to show you. This is also a musical instrument. Musical instrument, a spoon. Of course, the basic function is to eat and to prepare food, but you can also use it as a musical instrument. And there are really very good specialists who can accompany accordion players, fiddlers with these instruments. We know it from Irish music, but it is very common in Austria as well. Such idiophones, so to say noise instruments, are also very widespread. This is from Lithuania. But you can find similar instruments in Russian, in the Carpathian era, in Austrian, everywhere where we can find wood. This is an instrument used in Austria at Eastern, at God Friday, when the bells are silent in the church and the bells are replaced by these rattles. Similar instruments can be used as signal instruments, as children toys as well. I already talked about this whistles. And what's interesting about the children instruments and the signal instruments as well, that they are also not national instruments, but very widespread in the wooden part of Europe, so to say. Another instrument I want to show you is this very special balalaika. This is the way it was made in the 19th century, not with a monoxide technique of one block of wood, but also with a pumpkin. You can use pumpkins not only for Halloween masks, but also for musical instruments. But it has to be a very strong pumpkin. It took many years for me to find a proper pumpkin at the flea market. So similar instruments you can find in Central Asia and other parts of the world. So again, this is not about national instruments, but the principles are to make the instruments are very widespread. So the next instrument is this shepherd horn. It is from Lithuania. It is so-called natural trumpet because it has not finger holes. You can use only the overtones, if you can play it, of course. And it is made very tricky by a single block of wood, which is splitted in the middle, then carved out from both sides of the parts, the channel. And then you put together the halves with birch bark. It was not only used in Lithuania, but in large parts of Central and Eastern Europe, in the Carpathian region, in Russian and Scandinavian. And we know from historical sources that the Viking had similar instruments. But we know it from the more recent times, more like a shepherd instrument. Another instrument very important for shepherd is the bagpipe. Also made basically of natural materials, and you use cane for the chanter, for the playing pipe. Cane and the cow horn, and here this wooden yoke, and for the bag, goat skin. This is a Ciboni from Georgia. You can find similar instruments in Greece and the Volga River. And here you can see this mirror. Why? Because the idea was that, according to some mythology, the bagpipe is very attractive to the devil. And when the piper plays, the devil would come, and if he sees his own face in the mirror, he will run back. This was the idea, because many instruments are connected traditionally with mythology, with very old beliefs. So this is also a very interesting part of the history of musical instruments. This is also a chanter melody pipe of the bagpipe. I try to reconstruct. It was played in the Baltic region in Russian. And it's not an easy job to make such instruments. For me, it is very interesting how many very serious people, musicians, instrument makers, archaeologists, try to reconstruct these historical instruments with the historical materials, with the historical technology. And that's a great network of very good specialists and enthusiasts who help together. You have to solve many questions. How to make the reed that it will sound properly? How to find a cow horn? Which wood do you use? Which oil to make it more firm and that this has a nice look? So it's a lot of technology in this seemingly primitive instrument. And in the last 10, 20, 30 years, now with the help of the internet, we have a very interesting international exchange about knowledge, how to reconstruct this instrument. So it's again about historical technology, about to work with natural materials, with wood. It has something very attractive, particularly in modern times.